Hello everyone, this is Dr. Ahmed Rehan Khan here. Today I'm making this brief video on ECFMG pathways. ECFMG has recently released information for the pathway 2025. Before I start talking about pathways, there are a few basic things that all IMGs should know. So in order to be eligible for ECFMG certification, all IMGs need to pass USMLE Step 1 and USMLE Step 2 CK exam. The second requirement is that all IMG need to pass Occupational English Test or OET. And this applies for all IMGs from all countries. Now, once you fulfill the first two criteria, then you are eligible to apply for the pathway programs. And depending upon which criteria you fill for any of 1 to 6 pathways. The third thing is why ECFMG certification is important. IMGs can apply to residency and they can submit their application to ERAS without ECFMG certification, though that does reduce their chances of getting calls. But they absolutely cannot certify their rank order list, which is due by the end of February, without ECFMG certification. So long story short, without ECFMG certification, IMGs cannot match, period. Let's talk a little bit about Pathway 1. So ECFMG Pathway 1, they called it already licensed to practice medicine in another country. It means that if you have a fully unrestricted license to practice medicine in your home country or any other country, you are eligible to apply through Pathway 1. Now, for most countries, including India and Pakistan, we have 5 years of med school called, the degree is called MBBS, and then we have 1 year of mandatory house job or internship, 3 months of mandatory internal medicine, 3 months of mandatory general surgery, and then 3 months each of medicine and surgery allied. Once you do that, then in Pakistan, Pakistan Medical and Dental Council, PMDC, issues you a full PMDC registration under which you can practice medicine as registered medical practitioner, RMP, without any restrictions. And mostly those people would work as general practitioners. Similar process takes place in India, Nepal, and some other countries. So these pathways would apply for people who, after finishing their med school, have satisfied or fulfilled the criteria to obtain unrestricted fully license. Very important, unrestricted full license, because during even house job in Pakistan, we have license, but that is temporary, that is restricted, that we need to work under supervision. Let's talk about pathway 3. Now, there are a few things. So pathway 3, 4, 5, there are some basic prerequisites that apply to all of them. So basically, for pathway 2, 3, 4, and 5, your medical school has to provide the relevant information. And pathway 2 is for the medical schools that is not recognized by WFME. So I would not be talking about them because most of the countries, their agencies have been recognized by WFME. So pathway 3, we will talk about medical schools that meet eligibility for pathway 3. Okay, now medical schools, what they have to do, there's a portal called EMSWP. They have to go there, register themselves, and they have to provide information that during the med school, these students have fulfilled the skills, clinical skills outlined by mini clinical evaluation exercise or mini CEX. And I mean, I would not go to the details that the encounters are 10 to 20 minutes each and how much encounters they have to do. Very, very important thing about pathway 3, a lot of people ask me, is that who is eligible for pathway 3 in terms of year of graduation. So for this upcoming match, anyone who has passed their MBBS or gotten their MBBS degree on or after January 2023, so very important, so January 2023, only those people would be eligible to apply for pathway 2, 3, 4, 5. So that is very important. A lot of people ask me, there's a lot of confusion that You know that there are older graduates from Pakistan, India, other countries who do not do their house jobs. They come to US and they start taking exams after like many years. So the most important thing is that for pathway three, their medical degree needs to be on or after January 2025. Let's talk a little bit about pathway six. Now for people who are older graduates, prior to their graduation date is prior to January 2023 and they have not done house jobs, in other words, they're not eligible to apply for any pathways, then they will apply for what they call pathway six, evaluation of clinical patient encounters by licensed physicians in USA. Now, what they need is they need six real very important thing is that what is the criteria for acceptable physician evaluators. So long story short, and I'm sharing the detail, you can visit the website, is that they need to be primary care physicians. That includes internal medicine, family medicine, and pediatrics. They cannot be in their subspecialties. They need to have worked in that field for more than 5 years. So a PCP, a pediatrician, a family medicine physician, if they have worked for more than 5 years in US, then only then they would be eligible. And then there are other things that the student should not be paying them and all. Now then there's a criteria for acceptable clinical encounters, and I'm showing this, you can see the details. So these are some of the details that I wanted to mention, because there's a lot of confusion about pathways, and ECFMG has done a really good job. They have provided resources on their website. You can actually go search your country. They would show all the med school recognized by WFME, and they would even mention the pathway that the student from those countries and med schools can apply to. So I actually learned about pathways recently myself, so I just wanted to share my information which I have provided. It may have some errors. If there is, please comment and let me know so that I can learn too. But I think most of the information I have provided is through the ECFMG website itself. So I hope that helps. Thank you.